have to understand that sometimes we get it right. Sometimes we get terribly wrong. But spirituality, or the realization of spirituality, is not just the end of the part. It's not, it's just the beginning. That's business. We seem to think sometimes that once we have the realization or the knowledge of something, that that is the end of that. I don't need anymore. That's a nice way to be. Was the gods come from a time when you learned taught something? We have knowledge of it, but once the knowledge came to a particular level, that was it. It just seemed to stop. We didn't seem to go on any further in our life. Now that's a problem. That's a problem with all of us. I know that when I was in seminary, and I'm learning about scripture and learning about Jesus Christ, I said, well, I know it all now. I don't have to worry about it. I don't have to look at another book in my whole entire life. I gave it 8 years to it. I don't need any more. Well, I can guarantee you something. I learned more about Jesus Christ outside the seminary than within. Yes, I got knowledge of it. And we too. Get knowledge of it. Every time that we read the scriptures, every time that we look at our many catechisms. But sadly, most of us are illiterate. Our level of theology only goes as far as when we left our CCE program. We haven't expanded it. We haven't explored it in any other way. We left, we got our confirmation. As soon as we got our confirmation, we said, we don't have to do it anymore, we're finished. Catechism tells me I have to go to Mass. I go to Mass. Well, that's it. No more extra development. For some particular reason, though. I mean, this is this gospel. This particular gospel, you hear Jesus say, who do you think that I am? Of course, I don't think that Jesus said the same thing. Well, you are Christ, Son of the living God. Perfect answer. Perfect realization of who Jesus Christ is. Is that the end for Peter? Or is there more for him to grow into? At the end of the gospel, which is kind of an unusual statement, he says, you know, don't tell anyone of this that I am Christ. Now, hang on, we're supposed to spread Christ out, aren't we? And every time that we're not supposed to go and tell anybody about this. Why? Because he knew that if they went out and spoke about the Messiah, that they would get wrong. They had not enough knowledge. They needed more. Follow me first. Do what I do. Finish the commandments. Understand who I am. And then go out and be able to express. That's where we fall. We fall on that. Most of us come to a particular point and that's it. We're done. We're done. That happens with those who are elderly as well as those who are young. Many of our elderly people don't understand their faith either. Why? They haven't moved on. They haven't explored. Last Sunday I spoke about the understanding of what it is the sacraments are. But most of us don't use the sacraments anymore. we have knowledge of them, but that's it. The realization that contention is there, oh yeah, that's fine, don't be bothered, yes. Well, that's it. Nobody uses it. Wonder why. What is holding us back from actually using the sufferings? What is holding us from viewing something and realizing and acting upon that realization that they are there for our purpose? Do we know exactly what the sufferings do? And he was going to say, they're only symbols. We don't need them. That's nice. I'd love to be able to say I don't need confession. But I can gladly tell you that I do. I'd love to be able to say that I don't need the energy of the saint. And the end say that I need that too, I need that as well. The sacraments are there for that particular purpose. The most wonderful sacrament is the Eucharist. If you believe that this is the body, God, soul, and the ministry of Jesus Christ, then your logic thinking is that the same thing is needed in the sacrament of reconciliation and in the sacrament of sin. Those particular three sacraments are sacraments of healing. We come to the realization of them, but we don't understand it. I wonder why we won't move on. What if something else blocking us? Something that is not within us, but within us of understanding these things. We have knowledge. I can read every book on confession and find out lots of things about it, but there's no point in having about it if I don't act upon that. That's what Jesus Christ is saying to the disciples today. Even you say that I am, well, you're the Christ. Well, let me tell you a little bit more. Let me give you a little more insight into me before you go out and say things about me. Of course. Live my commandments. Do as I do. Follow me. If you do those things, you will know me. You will come. The action will follow. The realization. Most of our spiritual things, people who look at the idea that spirituality is not just something of knowledge. I could read Thomas Merton in my Days for Blue, or I could read Mother Teresa, I could read any of these particular books. But they mean nothing if I do not understand what it is I read. The idea is that we come to know God. Of course, we get to know him. Then we act upon it. We act upon these evidence. That's where confession, that's where sacraments come in, that's where teaching comes in. That's why we use the idea of teaching. That's why one of the most important parts of Mass, not just the reading of the gospel, it's the actual preaching of the gospel afterwards. So that you may understand something about the gospel. That you may be able to leave this church with an understanding of what it is God wants you to do. And more times that you do that, the better and easier it becomes. There is a falling off to the reaction. Spirituality is not just something of knowledge of God. It is the knowledge of God with the action that is interpreted into everyday life. That's the hard part. Knowledge or gaining about it is the easy part. Learning about Jesus Christ is easy. Many people do that. It's actually integrating what you know into your lifestyle, into who you are, and into the understanding that you are there with unity with God. And then the sacraments, especially the Eucharist, and the reconciliation are part and parcel of that very self. If you go through life without going to heaven, how can you say that you believe in Jesus Christ? You can't. Because you're not listening to Jesus Christ. Well, some people might say that's a strange thing to say. I love Jesus Christ. But if you love Jesus Christ, you will understand that you must go and ask Him for forgiveness. So that you can make a change in your life and sample. He didn't allow Peter and the apostles to say anything because he knew that they would get it wrong. Hold up a while, there was a little bit more. So that you can put what you know into action. Same thing with the sacraments. You come to the church, you come to receive communion, you come to receive the sacrament of reconciliation. Not because it's going to make you a better person, but it's going to improve your life. So that you will be a better person at the end of the day. When I came here first, I was told that I was preaching too much on reconciliation. And I said, okay, I'll back off a small bit. I'll stop preaching about it. It didn't change the fact that the confessional was empty. The confessional was empty before I came. The confessional is empty as I hear it seems. And although I preached about the sacrament, it didn't change anyone's life at all. Then I said, okay, maybe if hearing too much about this, you don't want to listen to me. So I back off and swallow it and preach about something else. What if it didn't seem to want to do? Still know that I need to make a confession. Don't know why. Is it that you know more than me, or you know more than God? If you do, hey, good for you. But God asks you to know this. Did you believe in this? Then you should believe. If you realize me, realize about me, and act upon it, it will form some worth of it.